Hi everybody, how's everybody doing today? So I'm back with this thing. We're going to be making again, but with this skewer, these beads that we did in the video prior. There you go. This time we're not going to use the empty caps of the pens or markers. Today we're going to use a skewer that I got the idea from Pink Poodle Crafter. It was her interpretation of my beads, her way, and after watching her do her interpretation, now I'm doing mine, inspired by her interpretation of mine. Does that make any sense? I don't know. Okay, so it's a floral stick, basically, like a skewer. If you want to go see how she did it, I'll leave the link down below. And we're only going to do maybe three together. And I found these little tiny filigrees bead caps. Now these wouldn't fit the other ones that we made. It's too tiny, you see that? Would not fit the ends. But I have two subscribers, awesome subscribers, that are going to send me some bead caps, which is amazing. Can't wait to get them. Then I'll really be popping these suckers out. If anybody's interested in trading, this is how I would like it to work. Or actually, is the only way that it would work out for me. Private message me, and what I'll do is, as soon as I receive yours, then I'll send out mine. That's how that's exactly actually how I'm going to do it this time. And so what I'm going to do here is sand these ends down with just a random nail file. Just to straighten it out a little. And see, the difference here with using the skewers is you don't have a center hole to worry about, or it's not even really worrying about it. There's no center hole to have to stabilize with the beads like I did previously. The only thing is to think about how to get the wraps at the end, the little cattail loops. And I really like how you guys have been commenting on my last video, my real-time video, that a lot of you, almost 75% of you guys, really enjoy real-time. You feel like you're sitting in the room next to me, or I'm sitting in your guys' room just chit-chatting and keeping you company. When I first started YouTube, as I mentioned before, that was the way I did it, because I felt the same way. But then, I started doing different things, and my art just evolved into painting faces. And when I paint faces, that can take me weeks, sometimes months. And of course, husband's coming in right now, so I'm gonna... No, I guess not. He's just closing the door. Okay, let's remove all of this particle. What was I saying? No clue what I was saying. You have to forgive me for this, because I totally forgot what I was saying. Okay. Now keep this upside down, because a subscriber told me the best thing to do is to keep this upside down. I agree. I'm going to keep it upside down. But I can't find anything to do that with. Let's see. Do I have anything in front of me? My goodness, no I don't. I'm going to have to figure that out later, but that is a fantastic idea. Thank you. Alright, get that moving. Keep it upside down over there. And Stacy did it differently, and Pink Poodle Crafter did it in a very different way. I'm going to go off of her idea, but with my own twist. As a matter of fact, I think I want to cut this going like this for this next one. Kind of like you do when you're making paper beads. Let's start this one. Why did that matter? It really didn't. Yeah, this stuff is really tough to get out of here. I think I'm going to open it up this time. Yeah, I think I'm better off. Yeah, we'll just leave it there. Don't fall over. Oh, your guys' comments that my voice is soothing and you guys really enjoy real time. I'm going to do my best to satisfy everybody because I did get that other comment that they enjoyed my speed through. So I'm trying to make everybody happy plus myself. And I'm really happy doing this video in real time. I actually have the time right now. And if you hear banging of metal and stuff like that, my husband's in the backyard working out. You might hear him shout. Okay, there's one. And on this one, I am gonna care about the end showing. Let's do the second one. It's incredible how people all around the world watch my YouTube channel. How I've inspired so many women. Yet you guys, let me tell you, you guys inspire me. Leaving me comments really keeps me going. Really, really does. I'm just gonna roll this. I apologize, I didn't finish my sentence from earlier, but I really can't remember what I was saying. That's cute. I like the green sticking out of this one for some reason. And I do like that shape. I want to use a fabric I haven't used. We go. I have some homemade sari. Excuse me. I did burp. And I'm going to cut that at an angle also. Still here. I guess I'm in my own head right now. Having my own conversation. I like the way that looks. I like all of the fraying. Okay, so we're going to do those three. Leave that open. My yarn, what I do with it. I had it here the last time. Oh, here it is. So I think I'll put the paper first. I have some tissue. It has stamping on it. And I'm just going to wrap it up. Just like that. And the next one, let's kind of put something different. This one has stamping on it. And I think that's good right there. And this one here, I'm going to do, this is just a flyer with color on it. It's a bit thick, so I'm not sure how it's going to behave. Probably should have some water next to me to relax the paper. I'm just going to run my nail to give it a curve so it doesn't misbehave that much. And on this one, I'm going to run the glue on the paper because it is a thicker cardboard. I'm hoping that'll help out some. There we go. It actually worked out. Hopefully it doesn't pop off right now. Okay. Well, it's trying. Let's put a little more glue. So we have these three so far. They're much thinner. Let me pull out the ones we did together. Just have them there on the side. Let me zoom out, bring these down here, and just pour these out here just for inspiration. They are much thinner. Okay, whoop, that went fine. And we have some fiber here, just some random piece here that I pulled, and somebody's going to be walking in right now. Okay, we'll leave that sticking up. It's really no big deal. Thank you. Can you close the bathroom door? Real time, guys. Real time. I want to know how much you guys heard. Oh my goodness. It's okay though. Oh, this is a pretty purple. Wow. I'm just... everything's been so quiet until I sat down here. And then traffic starts in the house. It's kind of like, hey, mom's recording. Let's start some traffic. And it's not the kids, actually. It's really just the adult father. Yeah. He needs attention. Oh my god. Nothing. You're just going to stand and stare. Go away.
I wasn't staring.
Yes, you were. Turn around and you're looking. Oh my god. Okay. Let's find the beginning of this here and catch my breath and relax and forget about what's going on behind me. I was gonna kill them all. Really would like to open my back door right now, but I can't. He's got music going. He's got banging barbells, and then he gets to talking to himself like Rocky Balboa. You actually will hear him screaming "Secret," just like Rocky screamed for Adrian. Like seriously. Okay, we're just gonna run this wire here, just very organically, like the other ones. Right? Then I'm going to make my way up. And I'm going to give myself some excess. Just because I didn't think this one through. I know what to do with these other ones, but this one, just because I was talking crap, totally shouldn't have done this. I can actually unwrap it. I think I will. No, let's leave the mistake there. Because it's fixable. I'm trying to tell you guys, it's fixable. With a lot of things that I do. But just because I was being a brat, I'm talking crap. That's what happened. Okay. So, this is how I'm going to do these here. A thicker wire, thicker than the red. This must be, let's see, about an 18 gauge. And I'm going to work off with a spool. I'm going to lock it in place here so it doesn't drive me crazy. Just like that. Okay. And for this one, I'm going to run the little bead cap to the end. Okay. Yeah, run the little bead cap to the end. Yeah, we're gonna figure this one out. Okay. Okay, let's do this. Let's bend this. Make ourselves a little loop. Oh, I should have put the bead cap first. Hang on. This is doable. This is doable. Let's put the little bead cap. Alright. I'm not even going to use a tool. I'm just going to freehand it like that. Actually, I lied. I'm going to use my tool. Just being a brat and a liar today. Yep. Alright. I'm going to trim that off. There's still no bead on here. There's still nothing here. It's just the wire. And we formed this. This one's very freeform because I messed it up. But we're going to fix our mess up, right? Okay. I can't explain step by step because this one is more of a freeform. There we go. Yeah. See if this works out. I'm going to go right back up in a second. Look at all the glue on my fingers. Oh, and thank you for the comments on my nails. Very nice, thank you. I'm going to form that little loop up there. Well, wasn't that a surprising news that Prince died? I did like Prince a lot. Really did. It's very sad how drugs take over people's lives like that. It's gonna miss out on a lot. Just because he didn't listen to the doctors. He should have stayed in that hospital. Okay. So, we're going to go wrapping back up. There we go. And back down. No, we're just going to... Yeah, we're going to wrap back down. It's going to be a chunky bead. There we go. It's actually cool looking like that. And call it. This excess wire, also I will wrap and tuck it. Wrap and tuck. Let's tuck it somewhere in there. There we go. It'll break itself off. There we go. Then I'll push that in. Okay. Not bad, actually. Not bad at all. Can't even tell that we used a skewer down there. Okay, let's do the next one. And that's what I'm going to continue doing. If you like, stick around. If not, thank you for enjoying however many minutes you were here for. See you later. Okay, for this one, I'm going to pay attention. But what I was saying earlier was, I wish I can open my door so you guys can hear the crickets, because Suit Lady and a few other ladies remember from when I first started how I would have the door open and they would hear the crickets and the frogs and the toads, if they're the same thing, I don't know. And we would just sit around last summer. Of course, they were at home, and I was here doing YouTube videos. And And that, back then, I was doing my real time. And they would enjoy my company, and I would enjoy their comments, and it kept me going. And they're still around, and it's almost 2 years later. I practically have all of my old subscribers, except a few. And, you know, as I tell my kids, the ones that go, well, they weren't meant to be. And that's perfectly fine. Lifestyles change. Relationships change. Some grow with you, and some don't, and that's for the good. And I welcome both, actually. Life experiences, learn what you can from those moments you have with those people. And here we go. I'm gonna wrap around. So you seeing what I did? It's loose here. Let me bring you guys in some. It's loose, you see? Nothing. It's not. There's a little mosquito. Last summer, do you guys remember all the mosquitoes? And drove me crazy, and one went down my throat. There it is. Got it. And I started choking on one of my videos. Okay, so you see how it's loose? It's nothing holding it there tight or secure. That's okay. It's perfectly okay. So I think I'm going to have to work off of this spool. And since this is not expensive wire, this is dollar store floral wire, I'm okay with working off of the spool and totally wasting some if I have to. And get my other bead cap. This was the original way that I had thought of doing. Not the original. This is the way I thought of doing it after I seen the pink poodle crafter do the inspiration of my video, which is very fun to see another YouTuber with a good following do something that I've done, that I did, and actually give me the credit. And I want to give her the credit back. Same thing here. It's not secured, but that's okay. We'll secure it. The problem with having the camera so close, I have a habit of leaving. So I'm constantly having to look up this little viewfinder up here. Make sure that I'm still here with you guys. That happened a lot with my original video. Totally would go off screen, so it's just the best thing to do on that one was to speed through it. Plus, I made so many. On that one, I think I made, oh gosh, like 20 of them. So now what I'm doing is securing it. And then I'm going to come right back down. Even though it's not that secure, that's okay. I can grab another wire and make it more secure. In 1 second. And what I'll do is just grab a thinner wire. Okay, so that fell to the side. That's okay. We'll fix it. This is why I can't have my nails painted. The paint I have on my nails right now is actually that UV paint. One of my daughters bought themselves a UV paint, and when I say they bought themselves, they literally bought it themselves. One of them has a job, and she buys herself some cool things. Do you guys hear that heavy breathing? I promise it's not me. It's not even the dogs. It's the husband. Do you guys hear that? Okay, so let's secure this. It's the husband. He's being a beast in the backyard. He's back there going, ah. I guess he has headphones on and he doesn't realize the strange sounds he makes while lifting those weights. It's still floppy. Let me see if I can fix this. I do prefer, after working with the two different ones, the marker caps, and then using the mandrels, is that what it's called? Skewers? I do prefer the caps. I really, really do. But I'm going to work with it. I'm going to bend these down a little. I could probably run down to my backyard, and here he comes in again. Does anybody want him? I need a little cottage in the back. You guys remember last summer when I was doing a video outside and somebody walked by and they blew a puff of marijuana towards me and I totally got contact high? Oh my god, that was terrible. Actually, didn't come out bad, but I do prefer the marker caps. I really do. When I say marker caps, just in case you don't know what I'm talking about, let me bring one out. These empty pins. And if you'd like more information on that, there's two previous videos. This is just my take on Stacy's take on my take. Okay, so let's try this. So I was saying I can run out into the garage and maybe get a hole going through there. You know what? Let me try to get a hole going. Just this needle. Let's see if I don't stab myself. I'm thinking I just might be able to. Let's find out, children. Let's find out. As long as it doesn't pop out through the side and catch me. Maybe I'll just force it down this way. We're experimenting together. We used to do the experimenting together lots before. I don't know if this is going to work. Or you know what? I just had another thought. I just wouldn't know where to find them right now. The little hinges. The eye pins that you can screw in. Oh, I just realized that. But the only problem with that is I don't think I have two. Okay, let's continue this one. I'll stop the camera and I'll see if I can find two of the eye pins. The ones to screw in. That's not gonna happen. Let's pull this out. Oh! Yeah, that's not gonna happen. Okay, I'm gonna come right back. I'm going to look for those eye pins. Yeah, I'll be right back. Awesome. Actually, didn't take me long to find them. So there are these things here. I know they're smaller. There are smaller ones available. This is what I got right now, so we're gonna work with it. You see how it actually is almost too big? But it'll work. So I'm going to screw that in. Hopefully I don't come out through the side. That's cool. Didn't crack it or anything. It looks big, but that's okay. that'll be the aesthetic of it. It gives it some personality. So let's give it a starter hole, a pilot hole. And pray I don't get myself. And pull that out. As long as you get a little pilot hole there going. Actually, I can do it with my hand and it's just fine. But I do understand there's people that have a hard time with their hands. Cool. Look at that. Look at that. That's awesome. Okay. Just need smaller, but that's fine. It's fine. It's fine. I got excited. So we don't even need to make V and I pins. We no longer need to make this since we have those. Now all we have to do is play. Awesome. I have other color that I would like to use. I have this wine color, which is not going to show up too much because I have a fiber that is the color of wine. This stuff is so thin you can literally rip it. Okay, let's do this green. And then finish it off by wrapping it around here and giving it a tug. I want to put some blue. This one I'm just going to run it through here. I hope I was on camera. I really didn't pay attention. This is a really pretty electric blue color. This is major gorgeousness with all this metal and fabric. It looks industrial yet feminine and mixed media-ish at the same time. You can take this project in so many other ways. Like you can head over to the Pink Poodle Crafter. She does these little twists down here to add charms. You could do that. You can hang it from so many places. What I want to do is hang, and if I find it, let's see, then we'll do it. Let's see. I'm looking for my jump rings. Those are not it. And here comes somebody walking in again.
Can't they just leave me alone?
It seems like there must have been a critter in my room and they took my jump rings. So, I must have some in here. There's a few. really size doesn't matter. Just grab what I have. Let me see if what I have in my mind works out. So I'm going to grab these, and since there's so much wire, I'm thinking I can hang some jump rings. Definitely got to close it really good because the wire that they're hanging from is quite thin. It's hard for me to use my left hand. Actually, this is what I'll do. Trade the tools. This one has that little spring back thing. It's much easier to use it on your non-dominant hand. Okay, so I'm just going back and forth until they touch really well. There we go. This one, since I did the first one, I'm going to try to grab more than one wire. There we go. Am I on camera? Yes. Yes. Just back and forth. There we go. And a third one. This one's very industrial looking at looking, isn't it? I didn't catch many wires. That's okay. Let's see how far off they are. It's pretty much far off, so let me get it a bit closer. Trying to catch this little wire that's right here. There we go. Oh, it's so relaxing. Until somebody walks in and I get crazy again. Alrighty. So we've got three jump rings hanging from there. Now you can hang as many charms as you like from that. I have some pre-beaded things that I might hang from there. It's always good to have pre-beaded stuff just hanging around. Actually didn't need the jump rings. I actually could have just stuck this pre-beaded chain directly to the bead. And it would have been fine. Some nights I just sit around and bead and bead and bead and make a long chain of beads and then put them on my desk and wonder to myself, wonder what future project that'll go on. That's cute. And the middle one can be this long one. Let's see. How will it look better? Like, yeah, this way. And then I can even hang this from a necklace if I like. or onto one of my wind chimes. Let me show it to you guys. Wouldn't two little birds look cute right here? Let me zoom out a little. I'm gonna have to zoom out a little more. There we go. Two little birds right here would look really cute. Even if I were to wire this and put it down here, let me zoom you guys out some more. See this glass? If I were to wire that up, hang it down here, it actually evens out the thickness of these. And then could definitely put a flower in there and hang this on one of my wind chimes. How about we just do that? Okay, let's do that. I have some spare wire just chilling. And what I'm just going to wrap this like this. And just to, for security reasons, I'm just going to twist upwards until it feels really tight. There we go. And then make ourselves little loops right here on this side. Actually, I'm going to need more than that, so I'm going to undo this and only run it twice. That way I have more wire to work with. You know, even once is perfect. Okay, now lay that back down. Come over here. And just twist like that. Come over here and twist like that. Grab these two ends and twist those. I like the chunkiness of this. And I'll just leave this here just in case I want to even hang something from that. Just going to lay that down as much as possible. There we go. Then I'm going to take advantage of these two things here. And open them up. And slide that through. Same with this one, I'm going to open it up side to side so it doesn't distort. Did I know we were going to do this? I knew stinking glue. I don't even know how long we've been on here. I totally lost track. I guess summer's coming around and I'm getting in that mood of just chilling with you guys. It's not cold. Some nice weather. Oh my god, that came out so cute. That came out really adorable. Let's see. Let me zoom out. Look at that. Now I'm going, Is this the beginning of a new wind chime? If you're interested, I have some videos of wind chimes. I even like this little mess right here. That's some resin. I really like that. I need to definitely hang something there. Maybe some bells to make it make more sound. But I really enjoyed this. I'm going to hang a few of these on some necklaces or something. I'll figure it out. I'm going to hang this on something. I'll figure it out. And then I'll come back and show you guys what I did. So I'll be back soon. Hi everybody. So I'm back and I decided to do another talk through video. Real time. So this is the end of the video that you just seen, or you're watching at this moment, actually. I thought I was just going to continue working through and add on to this video you're watching right now, but I decided just to give you a sneak peek of what's coming next. So there's the bugs. Summer's coming. Did you see that bug? I laid out what I'm going to do, and this is the one bead that we did with the, what is that called? A skewer. Yes, the wooden skewer. This is the last one we did where we added jump rings to, right? And you guys seen me do this, and you seen me put the bottle, little bottle in there. Then I laid it down. I said, what else am I going to do? What else am I going to do? And then I thought to myself, why? Well, I don't know that so many people will watch the video to the end and see what I ended up doing with the things that we made together. So I decided to just give you guys a sneak peek here at the end of our video and share with you guys what the next video is going to be about. And here you go. So if you're interested in seeing how I put this together, I went out into the garden and grabbed myself a piece of wood that was on the floor, a little stick. As a matter of fact, I gathered over 300 little sticks and put them in a basket for future projects, because I love using stuff from my garden. So yeah, if you're interested, this will be the next video coming up. Now don't forget to share with all your friends. Don't forget to invite some friends over and have a blast and turn my video on, put some tunes and create, be inspired, love each other, make each other happy, make yourself happy. If you don't have any friends that can come over, well, you're not alone. I don't, but I'm good. I enjoy my own company. I would enjoy more company, but at this point in time in my life, I enjoy my company. Yeah, have fun. So, sneak peek. Look, I'd never done this before. I'd never done a sneak peek before. Sneak peek, coming soon. Hopefully I can open my door also and let you guys hear all the crickets and frogs and barking dogs and yelling neighbors and all the good stuff that happened last summer will happen again this summer. See you guys later. Hugs, 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 and bye-bye.